Hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty. It's Artcast 437. It's day 23 of my 100 Days of Making Comics challenge, where I'm trying to get my comic, The Berserkonaut, going. And you can read it over at theberserkonaut.com. Let me know what you guys think, and let's get going. So I'm gonna go ahead and read a couple comments. I've got this one comment from a channel called I'd Rather Be Drawing. Let me see what this channel is. I'm gonna click in. So it's an art channel, and it's got 21 subscribers, so a new art channel. I'm going to go ahead and subscribe to the guy. And says, I'm proud to say I know nothing about this conflict. It sounds like a bunch of clickbait crap. Another bit of media trash to be sensationalized. I went to VanCAF last weekend and saw a hugely diverse group of creators and fans who love comics. Sincere art will stick around and people pandering to trends will fade quickly. Love the videos, Jeff. So what's VanCAF? Let me go see what that is. So it's the Vancouver Comic Art Festival. So it looks like maybe an indie comics convention in Canada. I was just looking at some of the creators. Craig Thompson was there. Katie O'Neill, Julia Kay, Kazu Kabayushi, however you say his name. I've seen him around here and there. I recognize Craig Thompson, of course. And yeah, it looks like a cool little get together. And I wanted to read that comment because I think it rings very true with what I think too. I think it is a lot of clickbait and just sort of kind of capitalizing on a big fight to sort of just sell books. And I appreciate you putting your two cents in there, dude. I'll be going back to watch some of your videos later. I had another quick comment that I thought I would read. It's kind of diametrically opposite to this one. MJSRVP is this guy's name, which I don't know what that stands for, but says, I think he is genuine. He's talking about Richard Meyer, and when I was asking, is he for real or what? He does this thing like a pro and he won this battle, but I think he will have problems in the future. I have three questions. I'm worried about this and even not being in comics. Can Marvel or other companies crunch a comic book artist just because they want? Are artists protected against this kind of menace? And Meyer got lucky, but if it was someone else, with a question mark. And he says, be well. From Portugal, Mario Vasconcelos. So thanks, dude. Thanks for the comment. I appreciate everybody's point of view. And I do appreciate this comment, too. And the thing about Marvel crushing somebody, if they want to, you know, I can't think of anybody offhand that they've crushed. Though there have definitely been people who have run afoul of Marvel and kind of felt their wrath, for sure, in the past. And, I mean, in some ways, like Jack Kirby did that, you know, by just leaving them. And then, you know, Jim Starlin definitely got some bad press off of them. And I don't know, but I can't really think of, like, specific instances where they went out of their way to fuck with them after they were gone. The big thing about back then was, you know, you left, and I think this is what happened to Kirby. You know, you leave Marvel, and Marvel's kind of like the top-selling comics at the time. And then you go to, like, DC, and, you know, that's where he created the Immortals and all that stuff. And then And it just doesn't work as well because there's just not as, you know, many fans over there. And that's kind of their revenge on you. Is that you're not with us, you're not getting the hype. Back in the day when Jim Lee and Tom McFarlane and Rob Liefeld and who else? Richard, or what's his name? Eric Larson. There's one more. I can never remember that last guy. When they all left Marvel and formed Image, you know, that was like the one time that I think that really worked. And it really broke the industry like wide open. I mean, it was like an awesome thing. And, you know, like it brings to mind like the one thing that I can think of where Marvel kind of went out of their way to sort of put somebody out of business. And that was like Malibu, you know, when Rob Liefeld, when he was initially doing Youngblood, I think he was just kind of doing it on the side and he did it through the company Malibu. People forget that, but that was sort of like the impetus for Image. You know, that's what the Image guy looked at, because like that first issue had like such success, you know, through this like indie company. And at that time, there were just no indie companies. The indie companies were minuscule. But Malibu offered, you know, Rob Liefeld some ridiculous, you know, royalty on the book. Like, you know, you take 90%, just come and do something for us, was basically like the deal. And so he did, and then he made a ton of money off this one book. And then, you know, I think that's really what got, you know, Jim Lee and Todd McFarlane especially, because I think he really was the ringleader. And thinking that, hey, there's a ton of money outside of this that we're not getting, and let's go get it, you know. And also their, you know, complaints about like wanting to be, you know, their own creators and like have an ownership of like the characters that they were working on. I think that's all legit. And I mean, I'm a big fan of Image, so I'm not going to talk bad about them. But when they left, that broke the industry open, and that opened the door for a ton of like small companies. And it worked well for Malibu, just like it worked for like Dark Horse. You know, Dark Horse was like a nothing speck of a company, you know, before Image. And then once Image broke open the industry, it allowed Dark Horse to get bigger. And that allowed them to get things like the Alien franchise or like, you know, the Star Wars books that actually grew that company into something. And a lot of companies did that. And, you know, it broke the industry. It broke it from that two-company industry of Marvel and DC control. And it brought in all these little players. And I think Marvel hated it. And back to what I was talking about is, like, I worked for Malibu when all this was kind of going on. You know, when the Image thing happened, I was working on a book called Lord Pumpkin for Malibu. And at one point, Marvel decided they wanted to buy Malibu. And they did it while I was there, you know. And there was a lot of, like, kind of speculation and talk of, like, well, what's Marvel going to do with Malibu? Why do they want them? You know, are they going to, like, take the characters and bring them into the Marvel Universe and all this kind of stuff? And what they did was, like, once they bought Malibu, is they just shut it down. They just completely shut the company down and just that was that. Why they bought it in the first place was to get rid of it. They didn't want another Marvel Comics coming on, and I think that's what they saw in some of these smaller companies. They didn't want the competition. So it was just an easier thing to just buy them and get rid of them, and I think they were really trying to bring back that, you know, two-company control of the industry, like Marvel and DC. And I'm sure if they could have got rid of DC, they would have, but you know what I mean. I mean, it ended up kind of working out okay for me, because that's actually when I got to move over to Marvel. Some of the editors kind of came and cherry-picked artists from Malibu before they shut it down. And I was kind of one of the lucky ones I got to go over. And that's sort of how I got into, like, working on, like, Doom 2099 and that stuff. But, you know, that's, you know, if you're talking about, like, Marvel as a company going out of their way to crush somebody, I'd say that's a good example. And that's what happened to Malibu. But I think, too, you know, you've got to look at it like this, is, you know, as far as like Marvel in this whole fight with like Mark Waid and Richard Meier, I really think it's more of a fight between Richard Meier and Mark Waid, or Richard Meier and whoever the hell he wants to get in a fight with. And I don't think that Marvel is really trying to crush this guy. I don't think that Marvel is like telling Mark Waid, hey, go mess with this guy, because it's just not what like big companies do. My guess would be that Marvel, if they're saying anything at all, and they're probably just not saying anything, but if they're saying anything, they're actually probably telling Mark Waid to like calm down, quit giving this guy all this press by arguing with him, and you know, stop it. Stop fighting on the internet. Don't go out there and do that, you know? Because that's just what big companies do. They don't want the controversy, you know. A couple people have said on the channel, you know, good publicity or bad publicity is still publicity. But like in general, like I don't think that like big companies feel that way. I mean, maybe people like, I don't know, Charlie Sheen, for example, you know what I mean? He got a lot of bad press there for a while, and I think he was reveling in it and thinking that same thing. Well, hey, you know, if they're talking, at least they're talking about me. But I mean, ultimately, I don't know that really helped him. But, you know, like as far as like big companies and corporations and stuff, I don't think they want that sort of hate, you know. I don't think Walmart wants people like, you know, hating on Walmart and stuff like that. And so, yeah, my guess is like Marvel really, I don't think they probably have anything to do with what's going on as a company, but I might be wrong. Anyway, I'm going to end this video. It's like I had a heck of a time getting yesterday's video up on time, and this is probably going to be the same deal, but I'll talk to you guys tomorrow.